Hey, Resurrection people, it's Pastor Jedediah. Hey, maybe you have a wall like this in your home. Maybe a wall with pictures of family and your family, but then grandmas and grandpas, aunts and uncles, cousins. I don't know, maybe you have a wall like this. And I want to think about those people on that wall with you for a second, those generations that have come before you and those generations that come after you. Because I think we live in a time where we are making some really important decisions, especially here in this COVID-19 season. What we do in this generation will affect many generations after us. You know, I think back to my grandparents and my great-grandparents, and I can probably get as far back as my great-great-grandparents. I don't know. I've never done Ancestry.com or any of those looking back in your family tree. But I think that would be pretty neat to do if you've ever done that. But what I know is those before us leave a legacy. And those that come after us look at the legacy that we leave. You know, there's a book called 1 Timothy. There's also one called 2 Timothy. But Paul, one of the writers of the New Testament, a follower of Jesus, writes to one of his students, a young pastor, and he, in the opening lines, this has always stuck out to me as I read Timothy. Paul reminds Timothy of the faith that was in his mother and his grandmother, in Lois and in Eunice. And I think about that in our family trees. Who comes before us and what was the legacy of faith that was passed down to you? We know a lot of things can be passed down in our genes and through legacies. Really great things, but also some really terrible things. I mean, you think about faith that have been passed down. I have grandparents on both sides, strong Methodists, strong Lutherans, but Christians all around. I have aunts and uncles who are pastors, cousins who are leaders in the church. I have a great family tree of faith that I draw on back many generations. But as I think about what we get to draw on things of faith, there's also some really terrible things that come down. We know that some things that are passed down generationally are poverty gets passed down, abuse gets passed down. We even have studies that say anxiety gets passed through DNA, through our genes. Those things get passed down to us. So as you think about that generation before you, or a couple generations before you, what's been passed down to you? Maybe the good things. But I also think of those who come after us. I've been reading quite a bit in the Old Testament, the Kings, and now I'm working my way through Chronicles, which is kind of a retelling of the history of Israel. And what I realize in there is that so much gets passed down from one generation to the next. King after king after king, you'll see the scriptures say, this king did what was right in the sight of God. And then this king did what was evil in the sight of God. And then his son grew up and did again what was evil. And then his son grew up and did what was good in the sight of God. And often there's a little bit of a trickle one after the next, where you have one king that turns and does what is right in the sight of God. And then the next one does right, and the next one does right. And then somebody in one generation turns and does evil. And for generations after that, two or three, maybe four generations, you have evil, and then evil again. And we learn from our parents to do evil in the sight of God. Or we learn from our parents and our grandparents and our great-grandparents to do what is right in the sight of God. But there's, in those telling of the stories of the kings, there's a generation that turns things around and refaces the whole nation back to God. I think we're in a season where this generation of leaders has a chance to do what is right in the sight of God that will affect generation after generation after generation that come after us. Not saying that your parents or my grandparents did what was evil in the sight of God, but every generation gets the chance to make the choice. God says, I put before you blessings and curses, life and death. Choose life. And so as we go through this season, I hear God calling this generation to turn to Him. And I think we have that choice. We have a great opportunity, this great pause, to either do now what is right in the sight of God or continue to do what is evil in the sight of God. We have an awesome opportunity. Think about your great-grandchildren, your great-great-grandchildren. I could probably say no one watching today has great-great-grandchildren. But think about your great-great-grandchildren. And if they look back, even if they knew your name when they're 20, would they know your name? And if they did, what would their parents say about you? What would have you passed down? Would have you passed down a legacy of faith? Would have you passed down a legacy of trust? Would have you passed down the stories of what God had done in your time and in your life, and that got passed to the next generation? Or will you have passed down what is evil in the sight of God? We have a chance to tear down idols. We have a chance to tear down what is just not faithfulness to God. We have a chance in this generation to leave a better legacy for the next, because today we are the leaders. So on the wall behind you, if you have a wall like this, maybe it's got a grandma or a great-grandma, maybe it's got your children or your grandchildren, but today, think about what kind of legacy you will lead. Because coming out of COVID-19, we have a chance to press deeper into God and leave a legacy of faithfulness. May God bless you as you think about the legacy you live for your great-great-grandchildren. Let's pray. God, we give you thanks. I give you thanks for my grandparents and my great-grandparents, Minnie and August, for Ruth and Arvid, for Elmer and Marcella. All I know were faithful to you. I have a great inheritance from them. Father, I pray that today in families you would break old generational curses, that you would turn the leaders of the families today towards you, that there would be a legacy of faithfulness out to the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th generation from now. That today we would be a people who turn to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, thanks for being here tonight. Maybe stand in front of your wall later and look at those faces, those who are before us, and those who come after us, and ask yourself, what kind of legacy am I living and leaving today? May God bless you. Till I see you online next time. Tomorrow night, 6:30, be here again. We'll be here. Good night.